You don't have to start at the beginning. The Bible contains 66 separate books compiled into one book. The 39 books of the Old Testament are the story of God and His people before the coming of the Messiah, Jesus. The 27 books of the New Testament pick up the story beginning with the birth of Jesus. If you're new to the Bible, the best place to start is the Gospel of John. This book, the fourth book in the New Testament, is John's eyewitness account of the life of Jesus. As one of Jesus' closest disciples, John's account is both riveting and informative. John's purpose in writing is to help us believe, making it the ideal place to start. These things were written to help you believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that by believing you may have life in His name, John 20:31. Pick a book of the Bible and work your way through it. If you're anything like me, you need a Bible reading plan or you'll waste precious minutes thumbing through the Bible, never quite landing. So pick one book of the Bible and read a little each day, one chapter, perhaps. If you read one chapter of John a day, which will take no more than 5-10 minutes, you'll read John in its entirety in 21 days. After reading John, move on to the other Gospels, Matthew, Mark or Luke. Next, read Philippians, Ephesians and Colossians, which provide practical encouragement and instruction for living the Christian life. Romans is jam-packed with essential doctrine. Genesis explains how everything began. Psalms is filled with heartfelt prayers that offer encouragement for every season of life. Work your way through one book at a time, and you'll never find yourself fumbling for where to read again. Read a little every day. Getting God's Word into your life doesn't have to take long. Start small, 5 or 10 minutes is better than none. Sometimes less is more, especially when reading less means you'll actually remember more. Choose a time and place that's convenient for you. Many people read their Bible first thing in the morning, choosing to spend time with God before daily distractions get in the way. But if mornings aren't your thing, don't sweat it. That you read God's Word is more important than when you read God's Word. Pray before you begin. Pause before you open your Bible and ask God to speak to you. Remember, the Bible is God's Word, it is God's love letter written to His people, which includes you. Ask God to help you understand His Word. Ask God to use His Word to teach you, to direct you and even to redirect you, when necessary. Ask Him to use His Word to help you know Him and love Him. Jeremiah 29:13 says, "You will seek me and find me, if you seek me with all your heart." God loves to reveal Himself to those who seek Him. Write it down. As you read the Bible, ask two questions. What does this teach me about God? What does this teach me about how I should live? No doubt, as you read, you'll find one or two verses that seem to leap off the page. Maybe they speak to an issue you've been grappling with, maybe they answer a long-held question, maybe they give you comfort or encouragement, maybe they provide an example to follow or avoid. When a verse resonates with you, stop and write it down, word for word. Pause to let the message sink in because these words are God's words to you. This practice has cemented God's word into my thoughts in countless ways. Sometimes I keep the verse with me throughout the day. Sometimes I ask God to help me remember it when I need it. Sometimes I memorize it. Be intentional about getting God's Word into your thoughts and you'll soon see your relationship with God thrive and your life change.